Hello everyone, I am Dr. Abdul Halim, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, Hari Singh College. So in this lecture, I will be talking about inverse mapping and some theorem related to inverse mapping. In the first lecture, we have defined what is mapping and 1-1-1-2 mapping. We have defined there and we have seen some theorem. We have defined also composition of two mappings and properties of the composition of mapping. Now we will first define inverse mapping when it is defined. Let F maps A to B be a mapping. If there exists a mapping G which is from B to A such that G compose F is IA, that is identity of A, and F compose G is IB. Then this F is called the invertible and this G is said to be an inverse of A. This G mapping is denoted by F of inverse. Now, what is the criteria? For a function to be an inverse mapping? So A mapping, F maps A to B is invertible if and only if F is bijective. That is, a mapping is an invertible. If it is bijective, then it is invertible. And if it is invertible, it is obviously bijective. So how to prove that? First, let F maps A to B is invertible. So by definition, there exists a mapping G from B to A, such that G compose F equal to IA and F compose G equal to IB. I and IB is the identity mapping of A and IB mapping of B. That is, IA takes every element X of A to X. Since IA, we know that identity mappings are bijective. So IA is bijective and G compose F equal to IA. So from that theorem, we know that F is injective. And IB is surjective, so implies IB means F compose G. So from this, we can say that F is surjective, hence F is a bijective mapping. So in the last class, we have proved that if F compose G compose F is injective, then this, that is second function, is injective. If the composition is surjective, then the first function, that is G, is surjective. So for injectivity we have taken this map, for surjectivity of F we have taken this map, that is, this is surjective. Even these are IA and IB are bijective, so we got that F is bijective. Now we have to prove the another part, converse part. What is that? If F maps A to B is bijective, then we have to prove that there exists a function G such that those two condition holds, that is, F is invertible. So since F is a bijective, so for y belongs to B, there exists a unique pre-image X in A. So we define the mapping G from B to A by G of Y equal to X for all Y belongs to A. Set of all pre-images. Then we can prove that G compose F of X equal to G of Y equal to X and F compose G of Y equal to F of G of Y. F of G of Y is nothing but Fx, that is Y. Y belongs to B. So see, this mapping takes every element of A to that element itself. And this mapping takes every element Y of B to the same element Y in B. So that is, this mapping is identity mapping of A, this mapping is identity mapping of B. So we got a matrix satisfying these two properties, so F is invertible. So this is done. Now next theorem is about the inverse of two composition mapping. If Let if a comma b and g comma b cross b to c is bijective, then they are mapping, then the mapping g composite, we know that if a map from a to b, g from b to c, so we can define g compose f, which is map from a to b. We have to prove that this is invertible, and then inverse is nothing but f inverse composition g inverse. So first we have to prove the invertible. How to prove? If we prove that this function is bijective, then we are done. So since f and g both are bijective, we know from the last class that their composition is also bijective. Hence, from the last theorem, bijective is equivalent to invertible. So this mapping is invertible. So now we will talk about the inverse. First of all, we have to show that this is invertible. So we have shown. So now since f is bijective, so this is invertible. So its inverse will be look like f inverse from b to a exists. And g is also bijective, so it is invertible, and their inverse is c to b exist. Now, since these two mapping exist, and c, if we take g inverse and f inverse, so first take this map and then take this map. So this will satisfy the condition of composition, that is the image of this g inverse containing in the domain of B. So f inverse g inverse c to a exist. Now we have to prove, see here again we have proved c to a, this mapping is c to a, and that mapping c g compose c is mapping from a to c, so their inverse will be mapped from c to a. So see g compose f inverse and f inverse g inverse, their domain is same. Now only thing is we have to prove that in each point their value will be same. So to prove that, since these maps are from c to a, so we have taken an element c z from c. Then since g is bijective, so there exists an element y in b such that g of y equal to z, and since y is in b, so there exists an pre-image x in a of y under f, that is here we can write g of y equal to z and f of x equal to y. So now let's calculate this function at x. So g compose f at x equal to g of fx, nothing but g of y equal to z, that is if we take inverse, so g compose f inverse of z equal to x, and what will be the since f is invertible and fx equal to y implies f inverse y equal to x, and g is invertible, g inverse y, z equal to y. So now let's calculate this function at z, because we need to prove this function are equal, this function and this function. So we have to calculate their value at point z. So this value is g inverse z, which is nothing but y, is again x. So both the function takes z to x, so these function are equal. So hence g compose f inverse equal to f inverse compose g inverse. Now we will prove, okay, some functional property or mapping. Let f maps a to b be a mapping, and p q be non-empty subset of a. See, these are subset of the domain. Then if P subset Q, then implies if P subset F Q. See, these are also sets, subset. These are set of B. These are in this part, these are subset of A. And F of P union Q equal to F of P union F Q. If P intersection Q is subset of F P intersection F Q. If P intersection Q equal to F P intersection F Q. When F is bijective, then only this is equal, otherwise it is subset. So this proof was simple. How to prove that these are sets? So how to prove one is subset of other? We have to take one element here, and then we have to show that is belongs to there. Then that is will imply a P subset P. So that's why you have taken y belongs to fe, fp, then there exists x belongs to p such that fx equal to y, because it's in image set of the p. So there exists an x and p such fx equal to y. Since we know that, given that p is subset q and x belongs to p implies x belongs to q, therefore fx belongs to fq also, that is y belongs to fq. That is, we have taken y an element of fp, now we have proved that y belongs to fq, so fp subset fq. So if we can prove that p is subset q, then this implies fp subset q. So how to prove this? See, here we know that p is subset of p union q and q is also subset of p union q. So by 1, we can write fp subset of f union p, f p union q, and fq also subset of f of p union q. So both of these are subset. So if take their union, fp union fq also subset of 1. Now we have to prove the converse part, that is fpq subset of f of p union f of q. So to do this, let y belongs to f of p union q, then there exists an x belongs to p union q so that y equal to fx. We know that x belongs to pq here, implies x belongs to p and x belongs to q, implies fx belongs to fp and fx belongs to fq, that is fx belongs to their union. So fx, we have assumed that this belongs to fx is what? Y. Y belongs to f of p union q. But here we have proved that fx is belongs to fp union fq. So this is subset of this. So from 1 and 2, this is subset of this and this is subset of this. Means they are equal. Now the third proof. Again, p intersection q is subset of p. So union is other way around, but intersection is this way. And p intersection q subset of q. So fp intersection q subset fp, fp intersection q subset of fq. So both of them lies inside them. So this set will lies in the intersection of both of them. So this is true. But fp intersection q not equal to it in general. Here is an example. Let f maps R to R is defined by fx equal to x square, take p equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and q equal to minus 1, minus 2 and 3, 4. So p intersection q will be what? 3 and 4. Fp is what? This is 1, 4, 9, 16 and fq also 1, 4, 9, 16. So fp intersection fq equal to 1, 4, 9, 6. But this is not equal to, see, this is bigger. This condition is satisfied. Fp intersection q is subset of this but not equal to. D number says this will be equal if it is injective. See, this mapping is not injective. Because, see, here it comes difference. Like it takes 1 also on minus 1 to 1 and 2 and minus 2 also map to 4. So, if in addition to the first condition, so this is true, what we have proved here. Now, if we take f is injective, then we can prove these are equal. That is, we have to show that this is subset of this. So, to prove that, let us take an element y belongs to their intersection. Then, is y belongs to intersection, so y belongs to fp and fq both. Since y is injective, y has a unique element. See, that is the one thing. So y has a unique image x in p and q. So y has unique preimage where? In A. So that means that x has to belongs to both p and q. So x belongs to p intersection q, because p and q both are subset of it. And we will get only one preimage, because if it is injective, so we will get only one preimage, in A. So that must be, that x must be belongs to both of them. So that is fx belongs to f of p intersection q. That is y belongs to p f of p intersection q. That is we have proved fp intersection fq subset of fpq. See, this is the point where the problem occurs for the in general mapping. See, here we have taken what p and q. We have taken those elements. See, here the pre-image of 1 is plus minus 1. So, in one set we have take plus 1, in other set we have take minus 1. Because this is possible, because this is not 1, 1. But here it is not possible, because there will be only one image, pre-image. So, hence it is. Another important theorem, similar type, but this is with inverse. Let F maps A to B be 1-2 mapping. See, there this is has to be 1-2. There it is just a mapping. And S and T be subset of B, subset of the right hand side. And we have to prove this. If S subset T, then we have to prove F inverse S subset F inverse T. F inverse S union T equal to F inverse S union F inverse T. F inverse S intersection T equal to F inverse S intersection F. See here, both of them satisfying equal condition. So again, we will prove logic. We have to prove this is subset of this. So we take an element from here. So let, so F inverse S is subset of A. Okay, so we have taken, that's why you have taken X. You can take any element, but X belongs to F inverse S implies Fx belongs to S. Since S subset T, so F inverse belongs to S implies F inverse belongs to T, that is X belongs to F inverse T. So this is proved. Now by using A, we can prove this. S subset S union T, T subset S union T. So F inverse S subset F inverse S union T, F inverse T subset of F inverse S union T. So their union also subset of this. For other parts, we have to take X belongs to this, that is Fx belongs to S union T. So, okay. This belongs to S, or Fx belongs to T. So F belongs to F inverse S. And this is not AND, this is OR. Here also we have to, because union means OR. F inverse Fx belongs to T. So X belongs to F inverse S or X belongs to F inverse T. So X belongs to F inverse S union F inverse T. That is F inverse S union T subset of this. So comma 1 and 2 we can say that this is equal. For the third part, S intersection T subset of S and intersection is subset of T. So by A we can get this and this. So from these two we can write F inverse S intersection T is subset of F inverse S intersection T. Now for the converse first, let X belongs to this element. So X belongs to F inverse S intersection F inverse T. So X belongs to both of them. Here it will be AND, and in the union it will be OR. So F inverse S and X belongs to F inverse T. So, because they, so that is Fx belongs to S and Fx belongs to T. So that means Fx belongs to S intersection T, that is X belongs to F inverse of S intersection T. That is these are subset of this. So from 1 and 2 again we can see. So we stop here. So, if you don't understand something or have any query, you can send me a mail. The mail is given in the first page. So, thank you everyone.